For this next piece, The Rite of Spring, we have a few of our students who are going to demonstrate a few things for you. The Rite of Spring was a ballet that was written by a Russian composer living in France at the time. And at that time, ballet was what we sort of think of as ballet. Graceful, beautiful, very fluid, floating, absolutely gorgeous, pink, fluffy tutus, etc. When he came out with The Rite of Spring, first of all, it pushed the limits of what instruments could do. This is a string orchestra arrangement, but originally, the beginning has a sort of bizarre introduction, which you will hear, and it begins with a very high-pitched bassoon player. And after it came out, people actually said, how could you write so high for a bassoon? We do not like this, and we think you're a terrible composer. Stravinsky himself actually started rumors that there was a riot at the first performance, because any press is good press. Once people heard about this crazy ballet, they were very intrigued and they came out in full force to see it. We did watch snippets of it in class, and I'm going to have them demonstrate a few of the moves. Perhaps you will see why it was considered so controversial at the time. I believe Aiden is going to play so that they have music to play to. So the plot of this is that it's in ancient Russia, back when there were tribes of people living nomadically. And in order to make spring come back, they choose a girl to sacrifice by having her dance to her own death. I think that the students will remain unharmed. But let's start at the beginning where the tribes are gathering and dancing in preparation. That is one of the motions that we did not associate with ballet, but that did happen during this ballet. Later on in the ballet, we do not have this portion for music. I showed them the original score. It's very complicated. Many time signature changes, bizarre time signatures. But this is the part where, during the sacrificial dance. Let's start with the one. Okay. So they're going to dance themselves to the point of exhaustion. One more. There's another motion where they sort of scissor kick their hands in the air. And by the way, we did actually all learn this during class. So if you ask your student, he or she may actually demonstrate this for you later. The girl becomes so exhausted, she has to use her arms to pick up her own leg to dance. And this portion is optional, but at the end, she does perish from exhaustion, and she is carried away by bears, which are the symbol of winter. We hope you enjoy The Rite of Spring.